Good morning, children. Welcome to your class. Today we are going to read about the Earth in the solar system. Okay, this is our chapter 1 in geography. If you open your textbook, go into the geography, lesson number 1, the Earth in the solar system, page number 1 and 2. Okay, now before we start our class, I would like to ask you a simple question. During the daytime, can you see the stars in the sky? No. During the daytime, what you can see in the sky is only the sun, clouds, and birds are flying in the air. You can see all those things. But if you want to enjoy the views of the stars, then what you have to do during the evening, night time, you have to go out and just look up in the sky. And you can see the beautiful stars are twinkling in the sky. So this is a view which you enjoy a lot, but still you will get many questions in your mind. How these stars are formed? How these stars are there in the sky? And how many stars are there? And I'm sure that you even try to count the stars. How many stars are there? But you cannot count all the stars in the galaxy, because there are billions and billions of stars are there in the sky. Okay? The bodies you see in the sky from the earth are called heavenly bodies. The bodies you see in the sky from earth, from your place, what are the things you are seeing in the sky? Those are called heavenly bodies or the celestial bodies, which includes, means they even includes the stars, planets, comets and the moon. What they include? They include the stars, planets, comets and the moon. So these are the heavenly bodies which we can see from the earth. Where you are standing, from that place you can see in the sky. Now come to the stars. Our next topic is, today's topic is, we are going to learn about the stars. So can you see what I am holding in my hand? Those are the stars and the moon. Okay. These are the stars and the moon. At what time you can see? In the sky? Only during the night time. You can see the stars in the sky at night time. Okay. The twinkling spots of lights which you can see from your eyes in the sky at night time are called stars. What they are called? Stars. What they are? The twinkling spots. Very small, small spots which are twinkling in the sky you can see at night time. They are called the stars. See, the stars are billions and billions of stars are there in the sky which you cannot count on your finger. Okay. And how their stars are formed? They are huge balls of very hot gaseous matter. What they are? They are huge balls of very hot gaseous matter. They are called stars. And what they will do? They are self-luminous celestial bodies. Self-luminous is nothing but which emits light and which are hot. So that emit heat and light. So they are, that is why, that is the reason they twinkle in the sky. Stars are formed because of huge clouds of dust and gases. How the stars are formed? Stars are formed because of huge clouds and huge clouds of dust and gas. Okay. Now, the thing is that stars are formed only because of huge clouds of dust and gas. How they will form? The clouds become more thicker, okay, and denser. When the clouds will become more thicker and denser, and they will start shrinking. It starts shrinking into a thick disk and starts spinning rapidly. The center of the spinning mass becomes hotter and hotter. When it starts spinning rapidly, the center will become more hotter and hotter. Then finally, a chain of reaction will form. A chain of reaction will occur where huge amounts of energy in the form of heat, light and other radiations are released. When it is spinning rapidly, and the center will become more heated and heated, and it is spinning rapidly, then a chain of reaction will form which release heat, light and energy and other radiations. So what will happen? Those are released into the space and a star is formed. Because of that spinning, those are released into the space and stars are formed. Stars are formed in very large clusters or group. Where the stars are found? Stars are found in very large clusters and or group. Stars are found in very large clusters or groups. Okay, these clusters are consist of galaxies. What is galaxy now? You can see here, galaxy is consist of groups of stars, dust, gas and other matter which are bound together by a force called gravity. Now here, what is galaxy? Galaxy is consist of stars, dust, gases and other matters which are bound together by a force called gravity. And there are millions of stars there in galaxies. And galaxies together make our universe. Galaxies together make our universe. And this type of billions of galaxies are there in our universe. You cannot count. Billions of galaxies are there in our universe. Now you can see our galaxy is a Milky Way. We call our galaxy is a Milky Way. Okay. In Hindi we will say Akash Ganga. What we will say in Hindi? Akash Ganga. Very good. Now what is galaxy? Galaxy is consist of groups of stars, gases, gas, dust and other matters which are bound together is called by a force is called gravity. And now what is galaxy? In galaxy there are millions of stars are there in galaxy and together make up our universe. These galaxies together make up universe and millions of galaxies are there in our universe. And our galaxy is Milky Way. Which is our galaxy? It's Milky Way. And what we call it in Hindi? Yes, Akash Ganga. That's right. We call it Akash Ganga. Now come to the constellation. Children, if you turn the page, page number 2, you can see our next subheading is constellation. Now can you see what is constellation? Constellation is nothing but we can see from the earth some of the stars in the sky appear to be arranged in a recognizable patterns. It can be in a recognizable patterns. Some of the patterns are in the form of animals and some in the form of people and some in the form of objects. These are the recognizable patterns. So we can see all these patterns. Okay. In the form of animals, people and objects, so we can see all the recognizable patterns. So these patterns stars appear to make in the sky is called constellation. These patterns appears to make in the sky is called constellation. Now since ancient times, hundreds of constellations have been identified by our scientists. Okay. Hundreds of constellations has been identified. And where they can identify all these stars, constellations in the sky only. Okay.